Steven, hello! You ready to shoot a senior documentary?
Allow me to initiate my playlist of royalty-free jazz.
My name is Lindsay Page. I'm an assistant principal here at Marblehead High School. I am also one of the facilitators for Senior Project. Myself and Mrs. Carlson, the other assistant principal, organize, execute, and run Senior Project for all of the seniors.
Sure.
So Senior Project is basically where seniors take their fourth quarter of high school and go out into the workforce or into a project-based field, in which they take 5 weeks to explore different projects and opportunities within that internship, basically working 30 hours a week with an additional 10 hours of project-based time that they need to do journaling and projects that they take home for their job, similar to, you know, what adults do in the workforce. Our goal, like I said, is to make sure that seniors are really actively pursuing their interests. It's a really good resume builder for students. It's a really good experience for students. And we really encourage students to kind of pursue and challenge themselves and to pursue their interests.
Right. My name is Dan Bauer, the principal of Marblehead High School. This is my first year. I think the Senior Project is an outstanding opportunity for seniors to take all that they've worked on, all that they've learned, and the whole school experience, pre-K to 12, and then take the last part of their senior year to put it into action. But all in all, it's a great chance for students to show all the things that they've gathered, they've learned, and then actually produce a product with that. That sense of independence, because that really is important for that transition to move on to the next level, where it's all about independence and the ability to think on their feet and utilize the skills they've learned and apply it. That's all what real life is. So it's a great opportunity, plus it's fun. And you get to the senior year, they've accomplished everything they really need to accomplish, and you know, they've gotten into colleges, they're pretty much at the end of their academic career, high school-wise, so it's a great chance for them to use that fourth quarter in a productive way. So it's a win all the way around.
I'm Jack McHugh, and I'm working on finishing the tiny house with these guys for the senior project.
My name is Ryan Ehrenberg, and my senior project is working on the tiny house.
I chose this for a couple of reasons. First off, I took the class and really liked it. And second off, I think I'm going to learn key carpentry skills that I don't know where else I would really learn.
I designed the frame. I decided it'd be nice to see it built.
Come along.
So far, we only have the framing up right now, but we'll see how it goes as we keep on going.
All right, so consider this. Kitchen space, sleeping space, storage space, living space. Boom. First, we got funding from the town so we could get the materials and supplies to build the tiny house. Then we sell that tiny house and hopefully a profit, and use that funding to make the next tiny house. You know, it's a self-supporting class.
Hopefully it turns out well, and we finish it on time. Everything's going pretty smoothly. I mean, and in all builds, I mean, you got some ups and downs. I mean, we've had a couple problems, but nothing too severe.
We lost a man. We started with 9, there's 8 left. Don't tell anyone.
I like the palm nailer a lot. That's kind of the favorite around here. I don't know where everyone else is. This is the nail gun right here. What you do is you hook the end up to the compressed air, and you basically just nail whatever you want. Squeeze the trigger, push in. It's got a little safety right there. If you're an underclassman looking to take this class, I definitely recommend it, or you know, possibly do this as your senior project in the future. And it's a good time. If you like building stuff, working with your hands, it's definitely a good time, and I would really suggest you pursue that.
It does give you a good insight at what it's like working on the field and like architecture and design, so it's nice.
My name is Luke Fobert, and I'm doing my senior project at Marblehead Veterans Middle School with Molly Hauptman, the art teacher.
My name is Molly Gurman, and my senior project is with Ms. Hauptman at the Marblehead Veterans Middle School, where I'm a teacher's assistant. I help students with their projects. Currently we're working on a graffiti project where all the students have to come up with a word that represents themselves.
Well, I knew I wanted to do something with students, specifically art students, because I feel like arts at the high school doesn't really get a lot of attention. I think the high school is an incredible art program. I just thought that maybe if I could help or guide a few students to want to take Art Studio 1 and then be on track for Art Major, Art Studio 4 senior year, then that's a great way to leave a little impression.
I really like these collages. This one has a really nice scene going on. It's not something that you would really see in a painting or anything.
Throughout my senior project, we've been putting together the Night of Excellence, which is a big art show for all the students. And that was last night, and we had all their artwork up, one piece from every student. It's a little tedious, more so than I thought it would be, but it's really great to see them all put together. And I think all the students really liked it last night.
We mounted black construction paper on cardboard or with other construction paper, and we did that for each single piece, which was like double mounting like 500 pieces. So it took us like at least 3 weeks just to finish all the mounting for the artwork. And after the art show, now that it's over, we mostly are just interacting with the students. The kids are, for a week or two, were pretty shy and coy around us, and then they warmed up, and now every time we walk in the room, they just start screaming at us and hug us and jump on us. It's kind of annoying at this point, but we still love them.
One student needed to do a reflection of his graffiti word onto water, and I helped him pick out the colors and show him how he could illustrate that so it looked reflected.
Now that we finished the art show, Molly and I have a lot of time, so we are building full sets of cardboard armor. The house scraggly spider, I'm the knight of the scraggly spider, and Molly is my shield maiden. And Molly's a bow and arrow huntress, and I have a great sword. It's pretty cool.
Working with Ms. Hopman at the art classroom is a really fun project, and I'm very glad that I did it this year.
I'm really happy I chose to do an art program, especially with younger students, because I feel like I've led a lot of kids to want to pursue art in high school, and even if they're just saying that to please me for the time being, I don't care. As long as I can get them to take one or two art classes at the high school, it'd be a great way to end the year.
Hi, my name is Mac Fisher.
So my name is Michael Comlin.
My name is Lucas Kupperman.
And for our senior project, we're working with Marblehead Youth Soccer. So each of us have one team that we help coach, so we're assistant coaches, and we travel with them to games. We're usually working with clinics with grade 6 to grade 8, and we work with the professionals and help them out in any way we can.
I think it's a great thing to do. I mean, you get to know a lot of kids, you can teach them something, you can teach them some skills, and I'm lucky that I can coach my brother's team, the U14 Fury, which is kind of like the A team for that age group. And it's a great fun. I mean, you get to know a lot of kids. They are pretty like old now and mature, so like they actually like you can teach them a lot. They get better. I got to go to their game this weekend, which was a lot of fun. They didn't win, but still.
Working with the kids, you know, I've learned responsibility and leadership. I'm helping the kids out.
It's teaching me how to be a good leader, a coach, a mentor, because the kids really like look up to you.
In a way that benefits both of us. So don't like waste any time.
Well, it's a bunch of different stuff. I mean, stuff I learned from my high school experience as a soccer coach, as a soccer player. I mean, simple skills, maybe even more complex stuff. It depends on the age group pretty much. Like we have everything between grade 5 to grade 8. So like for the little kids or little girls, you do simpler stuff, some passing, some shooting. While you do for the older kids, you do more complex stuff, stuff IRE. Used to do when I was playing as a coach, player, so yeah.
I'm Justin Gussard, I'm a boxing teacher here at Coastal JKD. For the most part, I've just been holding pads for people. I've been teaching people proper forms, techniques in order to actually accurately throw a punch, teaching people footwork as well. And I've been having a lot of fun with it so far. Not too many people have been coming in, but I have been having fun with who I've been training so far.
Well, so you want a 1-2?
1-2-3, and then I'll switch.
And then another three?
Yeah.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, slip, and another 3. Yeah, like that. So this is mainly what I do with my clients. I'll just teach them a couple different combinations, like, or a couple different punches as well, like try and uppercut. Just really quick. Gotta make sure you really keep it short and keep it close to you at the same time. I chose this because I've been a client for about 2 years. I really like how everything's run at this gym here. The owner is very nice, and I thought I might as well just give back to what I've been getting all these years, and I'm really enjoying being able to teach people what I've learned, and I'm having a lot of fun with it.
Nobody. I think I'm the toughest kid there, and if anybody wants to try me, you're more than welcome. Yeah, if anyone wants to see this afterwards and fight me, you're free to go. I'm just gonna win.
Oh, me? Yeah. Nothing too impressive here, you know, just... What is that? 200 pounds?
I'm having a really good time with Senior Project. I'm really liking everything I'm doing. I feel like it's not only strengthening me as a person, but it's really helping me get bonds with a lot of people that are coming in, and I get to train them. I think it's really been overall a good experience, and I'm glad I chose to do Senior Project.
What about Road Close to Heaven? Detour? We can't take a detour for the documentary, no.
Hi, I'm Nicholas Grader, the first, and I'm doing a senior project for Mr. Butters as a teacher assistant.
My name is Becky Twelfoven, and for my senior project, I helped Mr. Butters with review for the AP Euro exam. I'm not teaching any of the classes because I had classes during those blocks, and Mr. Butters definitely can handle that on his own too, but we will be helping him with organizing worksheets and articles for discussion for next year. So he might use those during class.
So for this senior project, I'm creating course material, also writing what is known as DBQ samples. DBQ is a writing section on the AP Euro test.
Here's one of them. This is just from a textbook, an example, a practice one.
It has been tough balancing working on my senior project with studying for my own AP exams, but now that those are over, I can focus just on doing this.
So, the things I've read are Civil War, Rise of the Nazi Germany, very sad, very sad. Creation of the U.S. Constitution, very happy, very enlightening. And World War II, another very sad topic, and many more. I've read many more. So, yeah.
And so, from these books, I take what I like for the class discussion. I mean, I'm a patron of history. And so it's quite interesting, intriguing. You know, terrible things happened, but it's interesting because they, they're relevant to this day. But this I've just gone through it, devouring each book I come across. So, essentially, I get these books. You can think of it as like the storm front breaking on a harbor. You see, I like to envision myself as a harbor master standing on the lighthouse, and then comes the storm front, and it breaks over me. It breaks very, very large over me, and the rain splits, and I
like it a lot because I really enjoy studying history, and it has been really interesting to tie that in with studying American government right now too. I'm planning on studying history and maybe international politics later, so this is definitely going to help me.
If I was not a fan of history, this process would have been excruciatingly painful, or at least boring, but I love history. I'm glad that I'm, able to do my own freelancer kind of education. And that's pretty much wraps up my little senior project. Thank you, I'm Nicholas Grader.
Well, I really enjoyed doing the senior project, and I think more students should be working with teachers for their senior projects because it is definitely a benefit to be still in the school and working with a teacher, but you still get like the freedom of senior project, and I think a lot of students don't realize that. So that's what I think.
So students will be...
Okay, I'm Zach DiPaolo. I'm doing my internship here at Coastal JKD. I'm teaching ground fighting to some of the clients, basically just like an intro to self-defense. I have a black belt in jiu-jitsu, so I know what I'm doing. I wanted to do it because I kind of wanted to get a feel for like teaching a class, guiding people. It feels simple, but it's not really that simple. You got to put a lot of work into it. Gave Chris Peek a bloody nose because he was acting the fool.
No wonder.
He's
okay, right?
Yeah, he's okay. We got stuff for that here. Balms, ointments, coagulants, sprays, antiseptics, a lot of anticoagulants. It's not a thing.
Yes, it is. That's what I just put in my nose.
I thought you put coagulant in your nose.
No, I roll back and get them like this.
So this is technically, like, this is a defensive position, but he can still hit me, but if he tries, go. Get him like this, and I can get myself over.
And here we have spotters and mats and cushioning, you know, people who know what they're doing, so it's safe. Yesterday I was bringing a medicine ball upstairs and I broke a fridge. I fell over, tripped, and I cracked the screen on the fridge. And I don't have to pay for it, but it still wasn't fun. Don't mess with Zach DePaul. No, I don't know. I don't have anything else to say. It's fine.
From the
Hi, my name is Ronnie MacRosen, and my senior project is I'm directing a performance of Romeo and Juliet here at MHS, and then afterwards I'm conducting just a series of interviews with people who've helped out just to round it all out. So I've been doing Shakespeare stuff for about 5 years. Found that I really, really liked planning out how everything was gonna go. So I knew that I was gonna do directing in the future, and this seemed like a cool way to get a first foot in it. So what we're doing is we have taken the story of Romeo and Juliet, we've taken all of, it's all the same dialogue, taken that and put it into the setting of 1920s gangster era New York. We've got this insane bar set that Thomas Saltzman and Neve Sullivan have put together for us.
The cool part of it is actually
just what I brought because I decided I needed it.
So here we have the church set, which is just for the friar to hang out in, and if we take, we unhook this, and then take these down, it turns from the church back into Juliet's bedroom.
We've got 19 members of the cast, 6 run crew members, assistant director, stage manager, assistant stage manager, 2 people up in the booth. I oversee most of what's happening, or at least I know who's doing what for most of the time. It's been exhausting. It's been absolutely exhausting. I only have been working on this for about 3 weeks senior project-wise, but we've been planning this show since about December.
Right now, we're just pretty much, figuring out the last minute things for the lighting and the sound. We've got all the transition music off of Spotify.
Nick Gould, who was the theater arts teacher here for the past 2 years, and when he left last year, it seemed like that show was kind of no one was gonna step up and do that show, and I'm hoping that me doing this is something that will inspire people to want to direct their own shows, and especially Shakespeare shows, and put them on here because more opportunities for the students. I definitely took on a lot, but I know that's the main thing that Senior Project has taught me is what I need to improve on. That's the biggest thing that I've learned.
I'm Ian Struthers, and I'm not on Senior Project. It's horrible, really. I have to get up at 6:30 every day to go to a school without any of my friends. I just sit in class all day, mindlessly doing work, and just kind of slugging along. I see all my friends building tiny houses, playing with $20,000 computer equipment, and I'm just here. It's lonely. So, so lonely. If I'm being honest, this interview is the most fun thing I've done all week. Every waking moment is just filled with regret.
I'm Jake Zotfried, and my senior project is an internship at Teshcon. Teshcon's a company that makes spectrophotometers and densitometers for the printing industry. The most fun thing is using the machines and building them and taking them apart, just because it's what I like doing.
These here are all disassembled units, and I took some of them apart. I'm going to be putting them back together. This is a competitor's product. We call it the stapler.
I feel like that's like over glorifying it. I glued a couple of pieces of glass into place. So this is a spectrodense. And what it does, it can sample a piece of paper and collect colors.
We get that same yellow on the screen, and it gives us 3 values, one with lightness, one with green and red, and one with blue and yellow.
And it lets you standardize that if you're printing. So you can adjust your printer to change any errors that you have in the press.
I'm brown. I mean, we could just be getting lunch at Kelly's, but we could be testing the labels for colors. I don't know.
Lunch break's here. You ready to cook up our burger?
I can't wait for this burger. Let's pop this baby in.
I'm Maeve Riley, and for my senior project, I'm painting a mural in C105, the music room. So when I come in, I have to take out my brushes, take out my paints. I have a little apron that I get to wear, kind of look like a baker. And then I get up on my ladder, and I start painting for the day. Before I started painting, I was doing it all out in pencil, and then I did primer, and now I'm working with acrylics every day. So I wanted to pick this project because I've always been a really artistic person, so I definitely wanted to do a project in which I could be creative. And also, the music department has played a really big role in my high school experience, so I wanted to do a project that kind of could give back to the music department and leave a tangible, like, lasting legacy in this room.
Yeah, I love this mural that Maeve's put so much work in. It's a wonderful addition to the classroom. So thrilled to have it here for years to come.
I really am enjoying Senior Project so far because I like how it gives me the freedom to choose something that I'm really passionate about and spend my time focused on that every day.
Oh, hard worker. She's here diligently 8 a.m., you know, to 3 all the way through.
This process has definitely taught me a lot about patience because painting a large mural on a wall maybe isn't as easy as I thought it might be. So I get a little frustrated every now and then, but I'm really happy that I picked this project because I'm really happy with how it's turning out.
Oh yeah, it's 3D, you know, it's adding a lot to the room, yeah.
I'm Drew Galley, I'm working with Mark Tarmey and Andrew O'Neill in the athletic department.
I'm Justin Fea, I'm doing my senior project with Mr. Tarmey and Mr. O'Neill in the athletic office. I saw kids doing it last year, and I was interested in what they were doing, and I'm into sports, and that was definitely a fun thing for me to be around.
We do like a bunch of behind the scenes stuff that make it easier for Mr. Tarmey and Mr. O'Neill, stuff that they don't have time to fit into their schedules because they're so busy all the time. We do all kinds of stuff. We get there usually around 9 and we check the fields a lot. We do a lot of stuff around the perimeter of the school, like on the tennis courts and the turf, making sure that's clean and ready to go for the day's activities and games. Being an athlete, like, I'm around sports a lot, and like I've been around those guys a lot, but like you kind of take for granted what they do day in and day out. Like, there's so much behind the scenes stuff that you never see.
Senior day today, so they're gonna be announcing all the seniors, like when they come out and where they're going to college and stuff.
Ice hockey scheduling, payroll for the umpires and like referees doing baseball, softball games, other athletic directors just asking if they'd like to play us for the next season. Been to Revere, Danvers, Beverly, Peabody High Schools.
Last week, me and Justin went down to Mansfield, which is we had to like bring a scoreboard to get repaired. And the guy thought it was lightning damage and we hadn't had a lightning storm.
Definitely learned a lot. I've learned what they do, like bus scheduling, like stuff we don't even worry about, but they have to figure all that stuff out. I definitely like it a lot. I'm doing it with one of my friends, and Tarmey and O'Neill, they're great guys and it's a lot of fun.
It's been a great time. I'm doing it with one of my friends, Justin, and we're having a lot of fun with it.
Hi, my name is Olivia Gentes, and for my senior project, I'm doing a fashion show.
My name is Annabelle Walsh, and I'm doing a fashion show with Olivia Gentes. We have a lot in common creatively, but she also brings to the table a lot of things that I lack and vice versa, so I think we make a good team.
It's called Politico. So we're basically addressing the relationship between politics and fashion and how fashion is often seen as a very trivial thing, but it actually can be used as a tool of change.
We've been painting on our clothing sort of political messages, talking about using your voice, feminism, equal rights, and things of that nature. We had to do a casting call for models, so we got models from all the grades in the school.
So basically, we've been, for the past weeks, going into Boston, going to thrift stores,
and we've gone to Goodwill, the Garment District, a few other consignment shops.
So we're basically just putting the clothes together. We've stylized them to each model. Today we're going to be taking each of the outfits and then having models try them on, pairing each look with a different model. And then next week it goes up, and then all the models are going to do the walk.
We had a grant from FITM, which is a school in California. They gave us a $400 grant to the Fashion Club. So we're able to use that to pay for the show. And it's something I've always wanted to do, but I never really had the time because I've been so busy with school. So I figured Senior Project was the perfect opportunity. And I'm going off to school in New York. I'm going to school for fashion, so I figured it was a good sort of transition from high school into college.
This is really teaching me that sometimes I'm going to have to be my own boss, and it's been a big learning experience.
At times, it's really, really fun, and then other times it's incredibly stressful. And even though we're kind of coming down to the wire and it's a little bit stressful, I'm also really excited to put on our show and have everyone come and see it.